In this video, I'm going to discuss how to set up and download your project files and unzip them from a compressed format. The first thing I'd strongly encourage students to think about is before you even come in and download any of your project assets here, I would encourage you to think about somewhere on your computer making some sort of folder to store your files for the class here. Now, it's up to you where you do this. You could go into Documents, for instance, and to make a folder to store, you would just right-click, say New, Folder, and maybe I'll call this CIT-100 Projects. So now that I have a storage space for my files, I can now come back to the class website, and I'm now ready to download the zip folder. A zip folder, or a compressed folder, is a means for us to be able to share files and documents, but also save a little bit of space. When you are ready to begin working, you're going to want to come and locate under each of your activities or projects attached file. So I'm going to go ahead and click once, and you're going to get a little pop-up window, and it's going to ask you what you want to do. This is actually a spot where I see a lot of folks make a mistake, where they'll say open with Windows Explorer. You actually don't want to do that. So long as a file is in a compressed format, you can run into issues whereby it may not open correctly and it will not save correctly. So you want to make sure that Save File is selected, and then tell it OK. Now, I'm using Firefox, and depending on the browser that you're using, you can either come up and click to see all of your downloads, or you can navigate using your Explorer and go to the Downloads folder on the Windows operating system. So here you can see this is where my zip folder had downloaded to. Now, just so you can see here a little bit better, one of the big giveaways that you're working with a zip folder is you have a giant zipper on the front of it. This means that it's compressed and it has not been extracted yet. So I say I'd like to extract this folder. I see a lot of folks make a mistake where they will just double click and click through the folder to get to the files. Can't work with a zip folder or a compressed file like that. We have to go through and actually unzip it. So to do this, you can right click and there is an extract all option. So I'm going to go ahead and say extract all, and what it's going to ask me is where do you want to extract? Now by default on both Windows and Mac, it's going to want to extract into the location where you have your file stored. For starting out, that's fine if that's a little easier for you, and then you could drag and drop your file into your CIT-100 project folder. If you wanted to get fancy though, you could come in and go to Browse and navigate. In this case, notice it took me straight to Documents, and I can come into this CIT-100 projects folder that I made. I'm going to select my folder and tell it to extract. And here now you can see it's opened a new window for me, and here you can see inside of CIT-100 Projects, you can now see that it's storing all of my files here for me. I could even go one step further if I wanted to organize this a little bit further, and I could right-click in the CIT-100 Projects folder, make a new folder, and this is Learning Activity 3, and then I can just click and drag to highlight my files and move them into that folder. Now I have a little bit more organization as far as working on my projects, and I'm now ready to begin working on Microsoft Word.